So it's raw. So I'm just going, you know, I'm just going to just be me. Make this fast because everybody know from past videos that I can be extremely lengthy. I promise I'm working on that. So obviously, my scenario has changed just a little bit, but God is good. So this is just, I mean, if at the least, just evidence of willingness will really change your life. And that's all I really want to depict here. I even struggled with shooting this video at night because I thought it would be too flashy, and I didn't want you guys to be distracted by the fact, you know, by the lights. I want you to receive what the Spirit of God is trying to give you over the situation. I'm just using this, the world, as my platform to show you that through God, all things are possible. So just to keep it real short, so this is my fourth time in Vegas. And, man, this number four just keeps ringing and ringing and ringing, and I'm starting to understand how it ties into what God has planned for me. So when I first went live, my first live was a testimony straight from my heart. It was raw. I was honest about everything that I've endured from being a child all the way up until now. And then I introduced the fact that I will be going shooting these videos and sharing the good news with you guys, and just kind of traveling the world, bringing you with me, you know, just trying to spread hope, you know, spread love, encourage you, to show you know, you guys know me. We're from Delaware, small wonder. And here I am in across the country on God's time. You know, I didn't have to work too hard. I just kind of let it go, and here we are, guys. So, you know, let me just encourage you, because people are going to doubt you. You know, they're going to doubt you, but you have to hang on to what God has given you. From the first video, I mentioned that I will be traveling the world to share the love of God. And, you know, today is the first day of that becoming manifest. And this is, you know, that was almost like a prophecy, because I said it not really knowing, not having the resources, not having the capabilities as far as, you know, when it comes to the resources, but God. Because here we are, and with very little effort, I am able to go live with you guys to kind of just show you God. He loves you, and He wants this for you. Everybody fits in the body in a certain way. My gift and my calling is not your gift and your calling, but we all have gifts and calling. When we work together, then we can really be, we can really begin to help each other out and reap the full benefits. So I want to start off by addressing a topic of how, you know, because once I get that testimony, I begin to get people coming to me, asking me, questioning me about theology school, questioning me about my knowledge, how long I've been a Christian, how much work I've put into this, and I really didn't have no answer. And for a while, I was real baffled about what to say to a person that was questioning my authority, right? So I'm gonna just go to the scripture. I know I don't use the scripture, I normally freelance, but this is very important because I need everyone to understand right here. So here we go. If you can, go to Luke 12:8-10. I'm just going to read that because I'm about to just give you scriptures that confirm what God is doing. That's all. Real simple. Luke 12:8-10 says, I tell you, whoever... You know what? No, let's go to another one real quick. I'm sorry. We're going to go to 1 John first. Okay? Give me a second. Okay, 1 John, right here, 1 John 2:27, it's all right, it says, so, 1 John 2:27, as for you, me, you, the anointing you received from him remains in you, in me, and you do not need anyone to teach you. I apologize for my tone because I know that came out kind of hardy, but I feel real strong about this topic because everybody's trying to tell me what God is doing in my life. So forgive me for that tone, but I just need to read that again. It says, and you do not need anyone to teach you, but as his anointing teaches you about all things and is that And as that anointing is real, not counterfeit, just as it has taught you, remain in him. So that's saying that, that's confirming to me that I can be comfortable knowing that the spirit that dwells in me, that's you know, that's on me every day, is official. It's official. So another one to back that one up was the one I was going to go to first. Luke chapter 12:8-10. It says, I tell you, whoever publicly acknowledges me before others, the Son of Man will also acknowledge before the angels of God. Okay? What am I doing? I'm acknowledging him in public. That's all it takes. Being courageous enough to stand up for what I believe in. I believe in Christ. I believe his blood covers. His blood has covered my life. And as a result, you're watching the fruits of that labor. I really ain't did nothing. But let me go on. But whoever disowns me before others will be disowned before the angels of God. Here we go. And anyone who speaks a word against the Son of Man will be forgiven. So you can talk about Jesus. You can talk about the Son of Man, right? Okay, but anyone who blasphemes against the Holy Spirit will not be forgiven. So what does that look like? That looks like you seeing me and you knowing that the Spirit of God is dwelling inside of me, and that I'm just trying to exercise love, and I'm just trying to exercise his, just show you God. And you looking at me and seeing that that Spirit is on me, and then you deny it. You give me a hard time. You persecute me. You know, you condemn me. You know, you try to make my decisions about a worldly thing instead of a spiritual thing. Your eyes are closed, and therefore you fall in a position of blaspheming the Holy Spirit, because that same Spirit is inside of me. All I'm saying, you don't have to trust me. Just trust God. Seek him, and he will confirm the things that I am trying to share with you. I'm just walking in my purpose and encouraging everyone else to do so in order to reap the full benefit of being a kingdom child. So going on, I'm going to keep moving, because he also told me that, you know, I don't need to worry, you know. Let's see, let's just go on. Like, so I, you know, spoke before some pastors. After this testimony, I got confronted with some pastors, a couple Christians that have been in the Word, and Christians for like over 40 years. Hours of conversation, just back and forth of them trying to gain more understanding about what is going on in my life. And this is what the Lord has given me to them. Okay, so, okay, Luke 12:11-2 states, when you are brought before the synagogue, rulers and authorities, do not worry about how you will defend yourself or what you will say, for the Holy Spirit will teach you at that time what to say. That's why whenever I open my mouth in front of a camera, the Spirit of God takes over. You're hearing my voice, but it is God's voice. I am being used by God to just display his love. I'm just willing, so he's using me. And that's all that you're witnessing here. That's it. Another respect in my hometown. You know, the Lord had to show me, because I'm so passionate about what I wanted to do. Went to my family, friends, everybody. And a lot of it was I didn't really get the respect. I won't say that everybody was being disrespectful, but I wasn't getting, the Spirit of God in me wasn't getting the respect that it deserved, that he deserves. And Jesus confirmed that to me through the scripture in Mark chapter 6. That it's okay, because this is going to happen. This is the Spirit of God comforting me along this process, allowing me to know that this is going to be okay, because these scriptures is God's voice. Mark 6:4, Jesus said to them, a prophet is not without honor except in his own town, among his relatives and all the, and his family, in his own house, no respect. And that's okay, because I don't need it. Because see, now the Lord has positioned me to be in a place where I will begin to gain the respect that I deserve. He will get the glory from what I'm doing, because all I want to do is share his love. He loves us. He loves you. And if we can just kind of come to the knowledge of that, however it takes, contact me. I encourage you, if you're struggling with anything in your spirit that's going to limit you from being able to reap the full benefit of what God has for you, contact me. You got my information. You got my number. I'm here for you. I have been sent from heaven here for you to help you along this path of preparation. The awareness of the Spirit is important. The awareness of the blood covering your sins is important. You have to know that Christ's blood is covering your sins in order for you to operate in the fullness of his grace. Without his grace, you're going to be held accountable for your sins. We can't afford to be held accountable for our sins, because no one can cover their own sins. Christ's blood is the only thing that does that. So, guys, this is just an outpour. I love you. I love you guys. I love you guys. And if it wasn't for the sun beaming in my face, I would take my glasses off because I want to see. I want you to be able to see my eyes. But it's the sun hurts, and it's just, I'm just not going to happen right now. I love you guys, and you know that. So, if you want to know what it is that God has in store for you, if you want to at least get on the path, let me help you. I've already paved that path for you. I went through it. I know what it's going to take. It was a little challenging, yes. A little scary, yes. But it's worth it. Look where I'm at. I didn't have to do anything. I didn't have to use any money or anything to get here other than just being willing and moving with the Spirit of God. And everything is working out, guys. I'm just saying. I love you. I'm here. Now, one more thing. All right? How many minutes? I'm doing too much. Can you see? All right, so what else I want to do is, you know what? I'm going to just close it out because, I mean, it's so much information. But, okay, I'm going to finish it like this. And as gentle as possible, guys, as gentle as possible, I love you, and this is as gentle as humanly possible. I'm trying to give you guys word, okay? It says in Titus 3:9-11, this is what helps me move forward and God's calling without worrying about the things of this world and anyone that wants to concern me about the things of this world. Okay? Because it says in Titus 3:9-11 that avoid foolish controversies and genealogies and arguments and quarrels about the law, because these are unprofitable and useless. 10, it says warn a divisive person once, and then warn a divisive person a second time. After that, have nothing to do with them. Can I say this as gentle as possible? I am not trying to be disrespectful, but I have gotten to too many conversations about God's word, his laws, and what God is trying to do for me. But it's over. I'm making this public now. Titus 3:9-11 says, avoid foolish controversies, genealogies, arguments, quarrels about the law, because these are unprofitable and useless. Warn a divisive person once, then twice, and then after that have nothing to do with them, because you may be sure that such a person is warped in sin, and they are self-condemned. I don't want nothing to do with somebody that's self-condemned. You shouldn't even be self-condemned. So if you're condemning yourself for any of your sins, then you're not real sure that the blood of Christ covers you. Okay, so you need to understand that you're free. You're not free to be evil. You can't use your freedom in Christ to be evil, but you can use your freedom in Christ to be free. Free to live your life in love. It's love. It's all about love. That's the key. Love is the key. And it's so we're so far away from it that it seems like it's such a big deal, but it's just that simple. We just got to love each other, guys. And from this point on, we know Titus 3:9. From that, I'm not arguing with nobody else about God's law. It's perfect. And if you have a calling and a purpose, I highly suggest you just start walking in that thing. At least open up your mind to the possibilities of this thing being the beginning of the rest of something beautiful for your life. God loves you. God loves you. I love you. And with that being said, guys, it's hot. I'm frying and I gotta go. And I love you guys. I'll talk to you guys soon.